My name is Surungi and I teach math at BCLUW High School. We have been a one-to-one school for 4 years. Our students have MacBook Pros, each student, and all of our teachers have iPads as well. The biggest change I've made is that some of my classes are flipped. So what that means is I record my lessons and the students watch those outside of class. And then when we're in class, I can work more with them hands-on, making sure they can master those skills, or we do explorations or activities. So that is a big change in my teaching style. I don't do that for all my classes. So in other classes, I might just use them for more exploration work, being able to visualize the math a little bit more. So we do not use computers every single day in all my classes. We just have to remember that it is a tool. So we pull that tool out whenever it's appropriate. That's a really hard question to answer because there are so many different technologies out there that you can use. So I just really try to keep in mind what is the learning objective that I'm trying to reach and which technologies will help them to really achieve that. Because with math, the primary goal is for them to still be able to do math. So they need to be able to manipulate equations or whatever the objective might be. So we need tools that can help them visualize it, help them with explorations, so they can master those math skills. So I just look at the technology that's out there and really think, is this going to help my students meet that objective? I don't really think there's any special classroom management technique. It's just having classroom expectations. When our students have their computers open, I'm walking around, they're usually doing some kind of an exploration, so I just walk around and make sure that they're doing what they're supposed to do. And then if I have something that I want to talk to them about, I just ask for their attention, and then I usually ask them to lower their screens. And because I teach math, sometimes I even make it fun for them and say, please close your screen to a 25 degree angle or a 70 degree angle so they can practice their angle estimations. And once I have them close that screen, then they can usually focus on what I'm trying to say. In addition, at our school, we have the ability to block certain students and certain websites. So if a student does get off task and they're distracted by a website, it's easy to go to the administration and say, hey, this certain student needs to have this website blocked. And so that's a great advantage. But again, for the most part, you just need to have classroom expectations and let the students know what will happen if they break those expectations. So our school gives the NWEA MAP test, as I'm sure most schools do. And with the one-to-one environment, it makes it very easy to administer this test. Since every student already has their own computer, they can just get on the computer and they can take the test. In addition, we can now access the results of those tests very, very quickly. So I can look and see how the students are doing as far as what their strengths are and what their weaknesses are. We can even see how long they took the test. There are all kinds of different reports that we can look at and really crunch the data. So that is extremely helpful. We have a very, very supportive administration here. So the first thing that they did is they made sure that we had everything we needed with the technology, the software we needed, the bandwidth we needed. We have a great tech guy, and they even hired additional help for him. So they've been very, very supportive as far as the technology to get that all in place. In addition to that, they've been super supportive of us because they allow us to take risks. We don't have to worry about planning a lesson, trying something new, and it really flops, and so the administration's going to come down hard on us. They encourage us to take risks. They encourage us to try something new. And of course, if it bombs, then we just figure out, okay, what went wrong with that? And let's try something different next time. So of course, we're going to ask ourselves those kind of questions, but they're very, very supportive of us. We have a great staff in general, not just administration. If we have a question with the technology, anybody can help anybody, and everybody's willing to help everybody. We have a lot of professional development time that's devoted to technology. So that's, again, administration driven to make sure that we have all the support that we need. And we even are really encouraged to take professional time to go to technology conferences, to teach technology conferences, to do whatever we can to improve our technology skills. So we could not have a more supportive administration. really encourage people to network with other teachers. Go visit other schools, see what other people are doing. Network with other teachers in your field. Talk to them. What are some great things that they've done? What are some great programs or apps that they're using? That's really important. And if you haven't gotten on Twitter yet, it's a really important step. Get on Twitter, get an account, and there are people all over the country and the world that are just wanting to give you advice. There are Twitter chats about education every single day. So when I was figuring out how to do flip teaching, I was on the flip class chat on Monday nights, just learning. I learned so much from them. So I really, really encourage people to get on Twitter and communicate and network with people all over the country. In addition, I think people need to just go. Just do something. You plan, you learn, you network, like I said, but then just do an activity. If you're so worried about doing something wrong or maybe not knowing the technology well enough, you're never going to get started. So plan an activity and do it. If it fails, then you'll just evaluate what went wrong and try again. And don't worry about not knowing the technology well enough. Your students probably know the technology well enough that they can help you, and that's okay. We have to realize that it's okay for our students to help us. So learn, network, figure out an activity, and get started.